the neck. Not an hour goes by in my clinic, no matter what I'm treating or what I'm doing with a patient, it's either their primary concern for coming in, but if not, it definitely is, oh, by the way, doc, what about my neck? It goes to show how important it is, how it gives away age, and how difficult it is to treat. So this video is extremely important because I'm going to go through the causes of it. I'm going to reveal my number one neck cream that I use in clinic, and of course I use myself. I'm gonna go through some of the ingredients and why it works. And when I go through why and how the neck ages, it will make sense why I use this product. One thing I see, I wanna caution you first off, is about hammering the neck with ingredients. So many people are trying to get rid of the banding, the brown spots, the discoloration. They're using too much retinols, too much exfoliation, AHA, BHA creams, and they're having inflammation. It's causing crepiness, and it's leading to aging of the neck, premature aging. So I'm going to go through today how we can avoid this, and in fact, can you use your existing creams that are on the shelf? Just take them and use them on the neck. Let's also look at a before and after. And just like in this before and after here, you can pretty much see the lines disappear as we're sliding across for this before and after. How is this achieved? How was this done? Let's go through it. Like and subscribe. Let's first go through the five ways that the neck ages. And how can we change them? Can they be done with creams? Do you need lasers? Do you need injectables and positives and negatives? Number one, of course, crepey skin, or sometimes we call it cobblestoning. And what that is, there's lines going, of course, horizontally, but also vertical in between, almost like a cobblestone look. And that's just crepey skin of the neck. So that's one presentation. The next is going to be fat, and there's either too much or too little, okay? And so it's that happy balance. And if there's too much, I'm going to go through a topical product or an ingredient today that actually can cause lipolysis or can help reduce the fat. But if you have crepey neck skin and there's not a lot of fat, some people want more, what do you do then? And that's when people talk about fillers and different things. But a lot of people will say with procedures, it got rid of my fat, particularly high frequency ultrasound, HIFU, or RF, radio frequency. Can it get rid of the fat? I have many videos on that. But fat in the neck, understand, it can be very important to look youthful, but also sculpt it. We'll go through a little bit of that balance. Number three, the dreaded platysma band. It's that band that goes along the neck region. And people call it banding, and you might hear people getting Botox, neuromodulator to treat that. We'll talk about that. Can that be fixed with a cream? And what are some options for that? Next is discoloration. Often surprising to people, when I say to my patients, hey, what about the brown spots, the red spots, the discoloration? And the discoloration can create an aging look by accentuating submental fat, sag. So discoloration and light reflection is very important, and that's something we want to address with creams, and which is the primary focus today, but certainly my other videos you can watch on lasers, IPL, and so on. Finally, tech neck. And why I'm putting this in a separate category, of course, so many people come in asking about it, but also it's multiple lines when people look down. So people might have a nice jawline and they're sitting there, everything looks perfect, but why they come into my clinic, they look down and they see multiple lines and folds. And that's a little bit different, and we treat that a little bit different. So let's dive in. I want you to be clear of all the five reasons that the neck ages, so you understand it's multifactorial and how difficult it can be. We're gonna look at some before and afters, and then I'm gonna dive into the ingredients of a topical product, and it'll all come back so you'll understand why that works. At the very end, I'm going to talk about some procedures that can be used in the neck for those people that want the next level up. But let's start with a few before and afters. So these before and afters I'm going to show you are just with a skin cream, Revision's Neck to Firm skin cream. And it looks like this. It's a nice white cream. It spreads real nice. But the pictures have, I'm not going to waste this, by the way, there's no way. The pictures are just with this product. There's no procedures done also. But before we get into the procedures, I will tell you and show you the product, show you some of the ingredients. And for those that want the procedures, they can stick around till the end. Let's look at these now. So if we look at this one, this is a great example of crepey skin. Look here, in the before, you can just see what I talked about, that cobblestone appearance. And this was used for 14 weeks on the neck region. And if you look at the after, you can just see there's tightening of the skin. Well, how do we know that? Because you can see in between the bands, look right here. I'll remove those markings so you can see, okay? And now you see that there's just that fat area that is less, and the tightening of the tissue, as evidenced obviously in this crepey area that was present down here. And once that's gone, it reveals a tightening of the neck. The crepiness is gone. Now, I said we're going to talk about procedures down the road, but I can't help but here, but say, if you wanted even more results, you want to go to the next level, these are good bands that can be treated with procedures, but also that's where things like neuromodulators or Botox comes in, because it will help more than likely those bands. But look how much better they look and how much more contoured that jawline is. And again, that's just with a cream, that's not with any procedures. Let's look at one or two more so you get an idea. Okay, here's another one. I talked about discoloration, and I also talked about shadowing with the discoloration. But if you look at the before here, there's a lot more pigment. And when I go through the ingredients, this is going to make sense why. Now, the shadowing in the before made those necklace lines, remove those marks, because a lot of people come in for necklace lines, right? And they don't bother me so much, but I know people hate them. You see the lines through here, and they're natural on so many people. So don't be obsessed with them. But when you get rid of the brown spots, you can then see the neck just looks better. It's brighter, it's more contoured, and the necklace lines are less accentuated, if you will. So that's just a more youthful looking neck. And again, that's just using the Neck to Firm Advanced, and that's for 10 weeks. Let's go to another. Now here is a much tougher neck. So if we look here, we have the bands that I talked about. We have the crepiness that I talked about. There's even more crepiness here and just some loose skin. She actually has quite a nice jawline if we remove the markings. Now we look in the before here versus the after. That's a great result for a skin cream. There, of course, everyone has the next level. If you want to go to that next level, I'll talk about the procedures at the end. But for a skincare product, and of course, even if people are getting procedures, they're all on a skin cream for the neck, because it works well, it maintains, and it's the most cost-effective, non-invasive way to get things done. The less procedures we ever have to do, the better. That's always our goal for a nice natural look. One more here. Now, don't forget the décolleté. People keep it exposed, especially those in warm climates, and they often forget to put sunscreen in the area. Look at the fine lines funneling in. Sure, we can use Sculptor and injectables, but for just a topical, again, I'll remove the markings. You look at the before, look at the after, pretty remarkable how you can tighten the skin, get rid of those fine lines. As they get deeper, as there's more sun damage, if people haven't prevented, certainly IPL, lasers, erbium YAGs, Sculptor biostimulators are often used in that décolleté. But for this reversal, for just a topical, this person can then maintain it, especially if they cover it up, use sunscreen, and protect it going forward. It's all about prevention, and again, the least amount of procedures we need to do. Let's go through the ingredients, and I'll share with you why you're getting these kind of results, what's in the product that makes it special. First of all, there are 8 different peptides used in this formula, including, and some of you are familiar with these, palmitoyl tripeptide 5, palmitoyl hexapeptide 12, palmitoyl tetrapeptide 7. Now, I mentioned that a lot of people are trying to get rid of the bands, the discoloration, using too much retinols and AHA exfoliating products, and they're causing inflammation. The nice thing about peptides is that they don't cause this harmful irritation. In simple terms, what are they? They are fragments of proteins. They're formed when amino acids bond together. For example, two amino acids are joined together by a single bond. It's called dipeptide, three, a tripeptide, and so on. Peptides, of course, a lot of people say, well, they're too large to be absorbed by the skin. So how can they possibly work? But what they are, and you're going to hear a lot more about this because it's the future of medicine, they are signals. They work by sending signals to other cells. The peptides in nectiferm work by signaling to the cells in the skin something called fibroblasts, and we all know of this because it's what we're trying to get to build our collagen. Collagen decreases at a rate of about 1% per year, as we talk about, but it isn't a linear decrease. Unfortunately, it comes and boom, falls off the cliff. So a lot of people say, oh, my neck looked great until all of a sudden it didn't. And that's often estrogen loss and that collagen. I call it the machinery of youth. The collagen, the elastin, the fibroblasts, it decreases. There's something called MMPs, matrix metalloproteins, we talk about a lot, that chew these up. So our machinery changes, so we need to signal growth of these fibroblasts and stimulate them to produce more collagen. Collagen, of course, is a protein that gives your skin the firm, smooth, youthful appearance. Natural and environmental factors, like I talked about, sun exposure, free radicals, they all cause collagen to degrade over time. So the result is fine lines, wrinkles, and sag. Therefore, the peptides in Nectiferm can minimize these signs of aging by boosting your collagen. Everyone's boosted collagen. Now, here's an ingredient you might not know a lot about that's very interesting. Methyl silanol, carboxymethyl theophylline alginate. How about that one? It's important, and I'm mentioning it because what it does is aid in lipolysis. I talked about that important balance of fat in the neck. You don't want too much, but you need some for youth. Remember, fat contains stem cells. So the methyl silanol, it's actually an organic derivative of silicon. It activates lipolysis, lipo meaning fat, lysis meaning breaking up of, so getting rid of fat. Theophylline alginate is a natural extract of green tea. Many of you love green tea. It's an antioxidant, a lipolytic, which many people don't realize it is, a skin repair and fibrotic and overall anti-aging ingredient. So those two together work to balance the fat and contour the jawline. Contouring is important. Now, that hyperpigmentation I talked about and showed you, Nectiferm also helps with that. The dark spots that occur on the neck, thanks to the inclusion of glucosamine in the formulation. Glucosamine provides skin exfoliating properties similar to, we talk about all the time on this channel, alpha and beta hydroxy acids without that inflammation that they can cause. The exfoliation speeds up the skin's shedding process to get your new layers and reveal those new layers of healthy skin that are rejuvenated. Here is a publication in the journal Research in Pharmacological Sciences showing glucosamine reduces the production of melanin through several mechanisms. It's involved in the upregulation of epidermal turnover genes and antioxidant related genes, as well as the downregulation of the cytoskeleton genes that are involved in the melanosome transport. These changes are associated with pigment reduction. So these are complex pathways, but know that this is a medical grade product. And I always tell you, medical grade products are a little more expensive, but they're studied to work. And that's important if you're going to be spending money on skincare, which many of us do because we want to avoid procedures. Additional ingredients in the formula that help fade hyperpigmentation include vitamin C and E, which are both powerful antioxidants. Of course, we all know C, it stimulates collagen production, one of the most studied products in skincare, and it reduces the appearance of dark spots. What's interesting is the antioxidant activity of the E can actually become more powerful when it's combined with the C. And it's for this reason that vitamin C and E are referred to as network antioxidants. Here's a journal article in Dermatological Therapy which explains, because the vitamin C regenerates oxidized vitamin E, the combination is a cosmeceutical formulation is synergistic, particularly in UV protection. And we know vitamin C alone works well for UV protection. Vitamin E is also known to strengthen the skin's barrier function and reduce transepidermal water loss. There's quite a few ingredients in the NeckFirm formula that can help replenish hydration as well. And hydration is all important. Remember, the skin on the neck is very different than the skin under your arms or the oil producing areas. So the neck is often dry, and ceramides are one of these. I have a complete video on their benefits, of course. I love ceramides, but ceramide 2 is one of the many different ceramides, a family of waxy lipid molecules that are naturally produced by the skin and are vital in supporting the stratum corneum. We often talk here that important stratum corneum. The stratum corneum is the outer layer of skin, which can be thought of as the kind of the brick and mortar system. The bricks are the dead skin cells, and the intercellular lipids or the ceramides represent the mortar. Without ceramides, the skin barrier is weakened and the neck ages quickly with any inflammation or weakness. So just like without mortar, the brick wall would be weak and unstable. So ceramides are key. The result is that skin can easily become dry, itchy, and irritated without hydrating factors. Other ingredients found in the cream are many, including algae extract, squalene, glycerin, tricaprolin, and many other kind of hydrating factors. Gives you an idea. You can certainly look at the ingredient list if you want a deeper dive. Okay, so how do you use it? Like with a lot of products, you're going to apply it in an upward direction. About 2 pumps of this will do the neck. I use it at the edge of the jawline here, and then the décolleté as well. People usually start, of course, you get something, you're excited about it, you want it to work quicker. They'll use it twice a day to start. When you get the results you want, you can back off if you want to once a day. Now, a lot of people are already on retinols. This works well with those. I would alternate. Retinoic acid specifically, I would only really use that once, maybe twice a week. Inflammation ages. I just see that time and time again. AHA, BHA creams, I do like them. This, again, works well. I would use this in both cases as your first step, followed by those, or alternate days. And then, of course, sunscreen and SPF after. So that's kind of how to use it. If you have questions, certainly ask below. But now, let's get into some of the procedures that you might want to take to the next level. Number one would be crepey skin, and you want to address it more. I like fractionated RF. That's my go-to because it resurfaces and builds collagen. Let's say there's platysma bands. Certainly in those cases, Botox, neuromodulators can work. Pretty simple to do, 20 units injected into the bands. If you do too much, A, at a certain point it's not going to work more, but also you won't be able to move the head properly, so that can be a problem. And if they're very big, if they're very pronounced, surgery would be the next step from there. RF microneedling, high frequency ultrasound, it can help tighten a little bit. Pigmentation, if you're still having problem or you want the next level, IPL, which is broad-based light with filters. CO2 laser could be done, but you got to be very, very careful. The side effect profile goes up. So it has to be a light CO2. I had a very light CO2 on my neck. I was in a clinic. I put that here. You can watch my videos on that, just like RF microneedling. What about fat loss in the neck with some of those procedures? It's all about who does them and the settings that they use. The balance of fat is key. You don't want to get rid of it all. It's why no matter what you do, no matter the procedure you're going to get done, a cream, a topical is part of it. We want to avoid more invasive treatments when we can. I want to hear from you. Are you using a neck cream? What's your favorite? Certainly give Nectoderm a try. I want to know in the comments below. I put a complete playlist up here on things you can do at home for skincare and to prevent and to maintain your beautiful, healthy, vibrant skin and body.